some of the most popular pages on Reddit are still dark. The message boards, known as subreddits, are a sort of gathering place with thousands, sometimes millions of people, and they're led by an army of unpaid volunteer moderators, similar to Wikipedia. Earlier this week, those moderators organized a blackout, effectively collapsing the website in protest of its new plan to charge third-party platforms. You see, for years, Reddit has been one of the most popular sites on the internet, but it has failed to make the kind of money off its success that platforms like Instagram or YouTube have. So now, leaders at Reddit seem to want to change how things work. But has the platform become so reliant on its community that it has somehow lost all control? Well, NBC's Dave Ingram joins us now. Dave, you and I sit together all day, every day. It's fantastic to have you here together in person. So you had an exclusive interview with Steve Huffman, the CEO. Congratulations on that.
Thank you.
How does he explain this dramatic shift in how Reddit is going to work and why it is that you know this new policy has created such an incredible kerfuffle over there?
Yeah, so he's a co-founder of Reddit. So he's been doing this for 18 years off and on. He left for a while, now he's back. And he's looking and emphasizing Reddit as a business, that it's not profitable, it's losing money. He wants to be able to at least make a little money for the company, for potentially its investors. They're looking at an IPO where they could sell stock to the public at some point, just like Meta or Google has in the past. And this is a sort of a watershed moment where you've got this standoff between the CEO who wants to implement these changes to get more revenue. And these users, some of them have been on Reddit for more than a decade. They don't want to see big changes.
I mean, that's the crazy thing about this, right? When we think about Reddit, right, the thing that made it so popular and so effective, I mean, the whole business model really is built on these unpaid moderators who for 18 years have been the backbone of the whole point of being there, right? They have these little sort of intellectual kingdoms that they kind of run. You go to that very specific subreddit for information about that thing and get involved with the community and the rest of it, right? Now suddenly he's referring to these folks as landed gentry. What's his plan here? I mean, his whole business was built on them, and now he seems to be making them very, very angry. How does he go forward from this?
It's a really charged term. And what he's saying is that these moderators, they're sort of running these fiefdoms where they're not accountable to anyone. So landed gentry, people who hand down their property from one generation to the next, dukes and duchesses, they're not accountable. And he's saying that they're sort of moderators are handing off control of these communities from one person to the next.
I have to say, I think it's rich, right, to hear the founder of a major platform describe his unpaid moderators as dukes and duchesses. But okay, you know, thinking now sort of at the bigger picture, I mean, do you think that this pressure that Huffman seems to feel and the changes we've seen at places like Twitter means sort of the end of the free, open gathering place that was the internet?
There are fewer and fewer of these old school internet places where it just seems like everything's open. You're not inundated with ads all the time. We have Wikipedia. Craigslist is still around. Some of these older communities. Reddit has been around since 2005. It predates a lot of other social media, right around the time of YouTube and Facebook is when it was founded. Yeah. And, you know, if it changes significantly, if it even goes away or gets diminished, I think a lot of people are going to be yearning and searching for something like that doesn't feel so commercial.
David Ingram, fantastic reporting. Great to have you with us. Everybody, give him a follow. It is really, really important to do so.
Thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Follow today's top stories and breaking news by downloading the NBC News app.